Hail and greetings all, Ragnarok Prepper here, and today I have a hobbit with me who loves to color and draw. So we're going to do a little experiment about survival with crayons. Alright, so what do you know about crayons? What can you do with them?
Start a fire.
Do you know that?
Yeah.
Have you done it before?
No.
So what do you usually do with them?
Color.
Color. But we're going to test this theory and see if we can start a fire with a crayon. So what we're going to want to do, we're going to go ahead and we're going to bust this tip off. Just like that. So now we have the tip broken off. I'm going to take the other bottom and we're going to heat it up a little bit. The wind will let us. Can you hold that?
Yeah.
And what we're doing is just heating up a little bit of the crayon wax so that we can do this. And that will help stabilize it. So then the obvious test is going to be if the fire, the flame, and the wind.
Probably.
There we go. If this will burn just like a candle. Well, the wind is definitely not being our friend. So I think we're going to have to move this experiment into the house. All right, so now that we've relocated inside the house, let's try this again. Once again, all I did was heat up the bottom of a crayon. We want to do that to make sure that it's stable. As we know, it's kind of hard to trust a crayon to just stand on its own. As we know, a lit object that does not stand well on its own would be a danger and something we wouldn't want to do. We heat up the bottom of the crayon just enough to melt some wax so that it'll stay on the plate. Then we're going to go ahead and light the top and see what happens. We had some flame, and it's still a little, let's see. There we go. And so we have our crayon candle.
We made a crayon candle.
Now, there are a lot of rumors out there about how long this candle will burn. Supposedly 30 minutes is what they claim. Though, from a lot of other reports I'm hearing, it's nowhere near that long. But what we're going to do is we're going to run a timer on this one, and we will let you know how long it actually burns for. Now, as you can see, it's actually a nice flame. It's not as pretty as a candle wick, obviously. Probably not as safe. I would think, especially outside with the wind blowing, we didn't have any success. But it is pretty bright, as you can see. It's a pretty big flame. It is putting off some heat, just like a candle, obviously. Don't get burnt. But you can feel the heat, right? Would that keep your hands warm?
Yeah.
If we didn't have any power or heat, you might be able to warm your hands up at least.
There's a little time
of fire. Mm-hmm. Just like in a candle. Now, is there anything else you think that you could do with this? Other than just get some light and a little bit of heat? What do you think? Uh-oh.
It died.
It looks like it's going out.
Yeah.
Hmm.
Let's get it back up again.
So what else can we do with flame? You think we could start a fire with this? Like a real wood fire?
It could light it on fire, but this wouldn't go off. Like a bunch of crayons wouldn't be a good enough fire.
Right. Interesting.
Is it a stain?
No, it's not.
It's dying.
I wonder why that is. Mystery. Let's try a different kind of crayon. Now, the first crayon we lit was from this box of ultra clean washable crayons made with solar power. Maybe that had something to do with it. Let's compare that to a normal crayon made the old-fashioned way. So here we are. We're just going to go ahead and break the tip off. We're going to go ahead and heat up the bottom. Let's do that by our plate.
It's gone!
Now I'm curious to see if we're going to have the same tunneling effect that this crayon had. How you said there was a hole going down in? As you can see, I think... But it looks like the bottom of an old firecracker, those old black cats. Now like the middle just pops out and you're left with hollow wax and paper.
This one looks like it.
Yeah. It's definitely big. Don't blow on it. It's bright. Warm.
Made a small puddle down there.
It looks like that may be even part of the problem. The new solar made crayon is not as flammable as the original. You can see that nice big flame there? So you said you thought we could start a fire with this.
Yeah.
Especially if you had some tinder and some little sticks.
Yeah.
This would light it. We also have the wax, which helps start fires, right?
Yeah.
Just like a candle. You think there's anything else we could do with it? What else can we do with a flame? We could test that theory. If we had contained the flame, it might cook something. You think?
Yeah.
Not sure how long it's going to stay lit. Or if even our breath is burning it out. We should test one of these solar crayons again. See if the green one is just defective. Let's try yellow.
we burned it up. We can make a rainbow.
Some cracking and popping there. See here, you want to be careful because the top of the candle, crayon candle, is not pretty. I'm sure that that's going to fall off.
Luckily, this can burn. Can't burn, but this can. So if it falls off, it falls off.
That's why we used it, to be safe.
About these solar ones. It's not. I definitely smell the paper burning.
Yeah.
And I'm sure there's other noxious fumes that we shouldn't be breathing there.
These are bigger crayons.
Yeah, I wonder what would happen if we used the jumbo crayons.
Jumbo.
Perhaps that'll be a future experiment. Yeah, that's what another dangerous part of it is, that ash could fall off and start a fire. So we'd have to be very careful if we were using this in a survival situation that we didn't catch ourselves on fire or anything around us. Cheese colored crayon?
I don't think so.
I think it was.
Well, it did say and, and then it says cheese. Crayon used to be like this big, and now it's this big. All that's left on the top is paper. Yeah. Old burnt paper.
Careful.
It's going down now. Now it's two. Now it's going on to another black line. Soon to the bottom. To the other side and then just came back. Oh, we're just left. Now all that's left is crayon and orange pieces of paper. Killed all the words and black lines. Just fell. in the water.
Say roughly 17 minutes.
17 minutes is how long this crayon lasts.
So, our little experiment, what do you think? Did it work?
Yeah.
So, we did find out that these new solar powered, ultra clean, washable crayons, we couldn't get them to light very well, huh?
No.
But when we went to a normal old Crayola crayon, it lit right up. We got a burn time here. We'll put the final burn time down in the right over here. But we also could try these and see what happens. We might get a way longer burn time where there's a lot more wax. But we also came up with an idea for another experiment, right? To see if we could make a cup of tea, maybe.
Oh, yeah.
So we'll think about how we're going to do that, and we can make another video. What do you think? Do you want to try that?
Yeah.
All right. So until next we meet, be well, and burn your crayon safely.